let's go to some of that economic data. Obviously, we have the RBA yesterday keeping the cash rate on hold. They are still concerned about inflation being above target. We know it's close to 4, and of course, their target band is a lot lower than that. Michele Bullock says part of the problem, Trudy, government spending. Mm. That's why inflation's higher than it needs to be. The Treasurer, though, well, he disagrees.
This decision is welcome because it recognises the progress that we've made on underlying inflation. We are confident about the Australian economy. We are confident we can continue to see inflation moderate. We're confident that we can continue to grow.
Trudy, he's happy to take all the kudos, even though it's been revealed today that their flagship policy, this is to reduce the cost of your power bill, $300 per person, per household handout. Well, that's yet to be delivered in New South Wales, Victoria and South Australia because of red tape. Now, he can't spin this away. The RBA are saying spending by government is ticking up inflation. Mm. It's economics 101. You better read the memo.
Well, it's not just the federal government in the RBA sights, though. I'd point out that states are spending like crazy too, particularly in Queensland ahead of that election. That energy rebate you got from the federal government, in Queensland you also got an extra $1,000 on top of that. So the states are making the situation worse as well. As for the politics, it's really fascinating to see Jim Chalmers now publicly disagree with direct comments from Michele Bullock, his hand-pointed RBA governor. Today he was put to him on radio this explicit quote that she had said about the economy being too hot, and his answer was, well, I don't accept that and I don't agree. But we are getting into the pre-election cycle, and I think we're going to see a little bit more distance now between the Treasurer and the RBA, particularly if we do see rates go up before the election, heaven forbid.
And I tell you what, when they're working around the strategy table of options to go early, options to go into next year, this is the number one issue. Cost of living is the number one issue, and playing hard into that obviously is rates, but also housing. We'll go to housing actually now, because in Victoria, there's a promise to build homes. We know there's a national build target of 1.2 million homes by the end of the decade, well behind schedule. But Victoria have all of these other projects inside that overall target. We hear today that they've quietly scrapped 15 separate projects and pulled the funding. So, Patrick, you know, the game here is they go out there, they make the pretty little announcement, we all cover it on TV that night, it gets into the print media, people think the homes are coming, and then a couple of months down the track, they take the money out of there, they scrap the project, possibly re-announce it somewhere else, but we're not seeing, these are phantom homes, we're not seeing anything built, and the journalists, up until now, haven't picked it up. Well, thank God they have, but this isn't good enough.
No, I remember Dan Andrews announcing that back in 2020. He was wearing a hard hat, of course. He talked about $5.2 billion for 12,000 new homes. It sounded great at the time, very grandiose. 4 years later, I think there's 3,000 to 5,000 homes built under this program, and the state government doesn't know where it's going to find the money to actually build the rest. And Dan Andrews, too, going back to 2022, he promised just before he resigned 800,000 new homes for Victoria in the next 10 years. He resigned. It sounded good at the time. And you look at the numbers since, there's no way in the world there's going to be 800,000. It'll be closer to 500,000. So you make a very good point. That difference between the announcement itself and the moment of reckoning many years down the track allows these politicians to make the most airy statements that they probably know will never come true.